We take for granted how easily a plane weighing over 500,000 pounds lifts off the ground with such ease. How does it happen? The answer is simple. It's engines. Newton's third law of motion is the fundamental principle in the jet planes. His third law states that for every action force in nature, there is an equal and opposite reaction force. Birds fly by pushing air. While the air is pushing up on the bird's wings with equal force, pushing the bird up. Mankind has made many things that push air. One of the greatest machines that push air is the jet engines. Speaking very broadly, aircraft need two things to take to the skies: lift and thrust. Lift is the upward force generated by the wings, while thrust can be defined as forward momentum that comes from an airplane's engines. Jet engines move the airplane forward with a great force that is produced by a tremendous thrust and causes the plane to fly very fast. All jet engines, which are also called gas turbines, work on the same principle, Newton's third law of motion. At the simplest level, the way a jet engine works can be reduced to just four steps: suck, squeeze, bang, and blow. Intake or suction. Air is smoothed and introduced in a controlled manner. Compression or squeeze. The air is compressed, which increases the heat and pressure. Combustion or bang. The compressed air is mixed with atomized fuel, which causes the mixture to burn. Exhaust or blow. Kinetic energy from the high-energy exhaust gases push past the turbine blades, which converts the kinetic energy into torque and transmitted through the internal shaft to the fan blades in the compressor in order to repeat the cycle, then the gases are purged. Now we'll have a detailed look on how jet engines works. When you look at a jet engine, the first thing you will generally notice is that the front is a giant many-bladed fan inside what is known as the intake. The blades act in exactly the same way the blades on a propeller or desk fan work. The engine sucks air in at the front with a fan. A compressor raises the pressure of the air. The compressor is made with many blades attached to a shaft. Each fan gets smaller and smaller as the blades squeeze the air into a tighter and tighter space, compressing the air like you would squeeze a balloon. The blades spin at high speed and compress or squeeze the air, making it much denser and hotter. The compressed air is then sprayed with fuel, and an electric spark burns the mixture. The burning gases expand and blast out through the nozzle at the back of the engine. As the jets of gas shoot backward, the engine and the aircraft are thrust forward. As the hot air is going to the nozzle, it passes through another group of blades called the turbine. The turbine is attached to the same shaft as the compressor. Spinning the turbine causes the compressor to spin. The ingenious part of the modern jet engine is that the intake fan, compressor, combustion chamber, and turbine are linked by a single shaft. As the hot air is going to the nozzle, it passes through the turbine. Spinning the turbine causes the compressor to spin, running along the inside of the engine. So when the expanding gases spin the turbine at the back, it helps spin the fan at the front, which keeps the process going and generates more thrust. Thanks for watching the video. For more videos, subscribe to my channel.